These are my results. This is the graph. And then I will post it here to motivate me every single day.
Amani? You just finished your first cat test, right?
Yes.
So we initially bought 3 cat, which is CAT tests from Kaplan when we first purchased the Kaplan Q Bank, right? So you were saving those for last, right? Like 3 weeks out, 2 weeks out, 1 week out. How much are we today from your test?
2 weeks.
2 weeks out. So you did your first cat test. And what happened?
I was expecting it's 265 questions because it says it's 265 questions.
And it is a time test.
Yeah, and it is time. So I went to my room to do the test without any interruptions because I have to finish within 6 hours all the 265 questions. Mm-hmm. And then at 75 questions, it pop up.
What? The test closed?
The test closed. So I said, what? What's wrong? Why it's closed? Well, then...
So you called me.
So I called you.
And then you said, listen, what happened? I don't know what happened.
Yeah, I did not press anything by mistake. I thought I pressed end test.
Yeah.
I did not press end.
So initially when we bought the cat test, we had no idea what the cat tests are. But apparently the cat tests are just an exact simulation of a real test.
Yeah.
But we didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's why you freaked out when it closed at 75.
Yeah.
So walk me through when you first started, you know, solving those questions until now. Were you anxious first?
Yeah, I was anxious and I was feeling that I'm not getting the correct answer, and then I was feeling all my answers are wrong because I'm not able to see what's the correct answer. So I was really upset because if this will be my performance in the real test, I feel I will fail. And then, but when I'm doing the exam, I was feeling that when I'm sure about some answers, it's giving me harder question, like SATA question. I was feeling when I'm not sure about a certain question, it will give me an easier question, which is not SATA. So I was asking myself, is it giving me a question according to my performance? But I was not sure because it's 265 questions. It's not according to your performance. But when it closed, I realized it's like
an actual NCLEX exam. So like back to when I told you about the feelings that you're gonna experience in the real NCLEX test.
Yeah, you feel shit.
So was I right?
Yeah, you feel that all the answers are wrong.
And really? Will that build your anxiety during the test? Like feeling that you're getting wrong answers?
Yeah, but I was trying to solve each question as if this is the only question I have.
Okay, so you took my advice on it.
Yeah, I'm giving it my best.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I click next, I will forget about the previous one. This is the...
And that's what you should do on the real NCLEX test.
When you press submit for the answer, you have to forget about it.
Mm-hmm.
Don't think is it correct or is it wrong. When you keep thinking about the previous question, you will lose concentrating about the current question.
True.
So you have to forget about it. Then start again as if this is the only question you have. To give it your best. Yeah, but I feel I'm happy because I got a green.
So let's show them. Like, so this is the first CAT test and you got overall of green.
A green, which
so
is...
So what does green mean? Let's go.
Green means standard exceed most expectations for performance. The student need to continue their current preparation activities for success. Just continue. While yellow means the standard meet minimal expectations and the student need for additional preparation. while red means the student
you're
is
gonna fail,
below absolute minimum expectation and he needs serious needs for preparation for to success in NCLEX. So I'm in a safe zone.
You're in safe zone. You're,
I'm in a safe zone, but I need to continue for these 2 weeks to prepare.
The same way you were preparing.
That same way, yeah.
So how many questions did you get right from the whole 75 questions?
45 questions I got right.
Okay.
45.
So you don't really need to get the whole 75 questions right to pass the
but
NCLEX.
The trick is that I got first 6 correct except one.
So you got the first
6 questions.
So the first question was a correct answer, the second was wrong, and then the next 4 were right.
Yeah, this is the.
And then you were fluctuating all the way like to mid 75 questions, and then you exploded up.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's.
I made a graph.
So you only hit the baseline once over there, and then you never hit the baseline all the way through the end of the test, which is amazing.
See, Angelina, I told you 2 weeks and then we will celebrate together, you and me.
So actually, Amani, you started studying 10 weeks out of the exam, and now you're 2 weeks out. So it means in 8 weeks, you were ready.
Yeah.
So 8 weeks of preparation. Look, Angelina is smiling because she's happy about your success.
Yeah, we will celebrate.
We
will celebrate
together. So actually, like 8 weeks were enough for you to get to those results.
Yeah, I hope I can get the same thing in the real test.
Because you still have 2 CAT tests to sit for.
Yeah.
So you're gonna sit for the second CAT and then for the third CAT before the test.
Yeah.
And that will evaluate your performance more.
Yeah.
And I think it will build your confidence a little bit more.
Yeah.
So when you go, if you pass by 75 as well. So when you go to the NCLEX, it's gonna be easy peasy.
Hope so.
I know you're gonna pass it. I know for sure you're gonna pass it. This is great. I mean, this made my day. I'm so happy about it.
Yeah, you know, I freak out when it closed. I said, I still have like around 108 questions. Why?
Yeah. How long did it take you to finish the 75 questions?
I can see 2 hours.
So actually the time left is 3 hours and 34 minutes, which means that it took you around 2.5 hours to complete 75 questions, which is amazing. Like, you should not be concerned about the time, right?
Yeah.
You should be concerned about focusing on the
each single question,
on the questions,
the correct answer,
and make sure you choose the correct answers.
Give it your best.
Yes, because time is not your enemy. So as someone said, time is not your enemy. Wrong answers are your enemy. A shout out to
Ryan,
Hamis Vlogs. She just posted a video about, you know, NCLEX strategies and what to expect. And I think that video was amazing.
Yeah, yeah. One more thing. I did my CAT after watching Ryan's tips for answering the
questions. Did it help you?
Yeah, it motivates me. Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. A big shout out for her. So,
Ryan, I want to tell you, you are the best. You have to do reviews for the questions, systems, diseases, whatever, because
she has to build like an e-course.
Yeah,
you know?
Because whatever I ask her, she has the answer right away.
Yeah.
So she has a good information, and she's a good teacher.
She has to be like a coach or something, like online coaching for NCLEX exam.
Yeah, because many people, they need your information.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
So big thumbs up for her. So anything else you want to say before we just...
I feel more relaxed today. I was really tensed about it. Yeah, so I will review all the results to see why I answered this question wrongly and what my weakness is, to work on it, and then I will keep on from now till the test. I will prepare more for the next CAT. I want to get more correct answers for the next 2 cats. Meow.
All right, as you saw it, guys, she has been amazing.
She passed her first CAT test with 75 questions, and that is a real simulation of the real NCLEX test. So yes guys, this channel is to help you get answers to your questions on your American dream journey. It doesn't matter if it's NCLEX, IELTS, lifestyle, we got it all. So make sure you subscribe, and until next time, peace out.